Tribe family and friends, we hope you're well. My name is Catherine and this is Kogi, my husband, and we will be bringing you this week's Elders Update.
Yeah, we're glad to and delighted to come to you again this week and just to check on you and how you're doing in this season and these different times, as you said earlier. And we trust that you are keeping well. Now, if you've been tracking with us on the just concluded sermon series, we went through the book of Daniel and we were getting through to see what we have as our pandemic survival kit. And we believe that you are having a good kit and you're using it and applying it in your life today. And I would just building up on that, I would like to give a personal experience that I think would be helpful for us to think about as we go through this this season. So I worked in a conflict zone at some point in my career in a country in Africa. And this was a place where there was a bit of political tensions, a civil war. And in this station, we were meant to have a life bag. So in this life bag, it was a simple a backpack or rucksack. And in this life bag, you'd have to have your most essential items. Say, a change of clothes, a travel document, some water, and some energy bars or some energy foods. So that in case of an ambush or in case of an attack, then you could just run away with this bag and run to safety. And if you don't have to come back to your station, then you could travel and move from there to any other place that that safety called. So when I was just thinking about this life bag, I was like, do we need a life bag in our spiritual lives or even in our, you know, normal everyday lives, you know, a bag that has your most essential items? When you look at the Bible, we see God call different people for them to accomplish a certain mission. So think about Moses and his staff. Think about David and his sling and some small stones. Think about Samson and his hair. All these people just needed a few basic things for them to accomplish that which God had called them for. And I believe that is the essence of a life bag. What do you need in your life in terms of what are the most essential items that you need in your life, even not only in this season, but even in your normal seasons of life?
As believers, we also need a life bag. And maybe we can look at some of the things we can put in our life bag to just help us in times of need. And some of these things, one of them is we need to spend our time in the Word. Because that's like our energy bar, you know, when we are feeling low, stressed, or when we feel we need to encourage someone else, we just need that energy bar and the Word of God that we can put in our life bag and that we can pull it out anytime we are in need. The other thing also that we need as believers also is prayer, you know, like to quench our thirst, like that bottle in the life bag. You know, sometimes when we are thirsty, the Bible says, run to me and I will quench your thirst. So we need to spend our time in prayer and just praying and seeking God's guidance in our daily lives. Also, the other thing that we may need in our life bag is community and fellowship. And it's amazing that even during this season, we've managed to keep our communities going, we've managed to keep our fellowships going. And one of the ways we've been doing this at One Tribe also, apart from Sunday meetings, is through the life group meetings during the week on Zoom. And so if you're not in any of those, we encourage you to please join one of those, because that is one of the things that has kept us moving as a couple and as an individual. Every time we meet on Friday evenings, we just get energized to move on. And if you're not a One Triber and you're somewhere out there, it's a group of friends, you know, people that you can share what you're going through, because with all that is going through, we need to guard ourselves, we need to guard our hearts, we need to guard our minds. So just having people that we can talk to, and even having people that, if you're going through depression or if you're going through sad times, just people that are experts in that area that you can go for counseling and just advice. So these are just a few things that we need to put in our spiritual life bag.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a time for reflection as an individual looking at your life bag. Do you have the most essential items that you need? Do you have, is your life bag, do you need to declutter it? Do you need to add a few things in it? I think these are some of the things that you can have this week to reflect upon that. Do you have the most important things in your life bag? And so, even as we consider this, we'd like to bring to you some announcements and some updates on what has been happening or what will be happening as we go forward. And I would like to mention one of the things that we are thankful for, that God has been good to us. He's provided. We have seen His provision in many ways. And we have been calling for people to give in the COVID fund. And we'd like to, as a sign of accountability, would like to update how these funds have been utilized, both from the COVID fund and from the and from the Mercy fund. And out of this we've been able to support about 27 One Tribers in different aspects of life, and a total amount of 236,789 has been disbursed from the beginning of April. And out of this, we've spent about 153,880 from the Corona Pay Bill. And this also has been dispersed to other organizations that are not part of One Tribe. Just to mention, Love Incorporated, Tazamania, Crying Sea Power, and Limuru Children's Center. And based on this, there has been also an initiative to form a social justice committee at One Tribe. And this will be looking at the different needs and having a long-term structure of how help can be dispersed among the members at One Tribe. We also hope that in coming days, we will be communicating ways in which members can incorrectly forward their inquiries, and their needs, so that you have the right information. I think there has also been an aspect of some wrong information has been passed through, but we hope that we can be able to communicate adequately so that you can be able to help us to steward the monies that and the resources that people give towards supporting each other.
And also, in addition to seeking financial help, we are also encouraging our family as One Tribe and our members as One Tribe to also seek for professional help in case you're going through anxiety and stress, and in case you're just going through some mental issues or emotional issues. And last Sunday, we heard from our Kutoa founder and Shay, and she spoke a bit during the interview, during the service, and we would encourage you to reach out to them. They are a Christian organization, and they are very affordable, and they mostly reach out to people between the ages of 6 and 25 years. So if you're going through any of those, please feel free to reach out to them, and their contacts will be shared down here on the screen.
So as we continue, also now we're getting into a new sermon series. And if you remember when we were talking about singing the song in captivity, Rigby Wallace, who was speaking to us, told us that this pandemic has brought some realities about life. That yes, there is more to life beyond our current life. We must remember that life on earth is a temporary assignment. And so we need to start thinking about eternity. And in this case, we will start a four-part series called Heaven. And this is supposed to help us just have a reflective moment and to think about when our assignment on earth is done, then what are we preparing adequately for what that is going to come? And so look forward to this. Please keep tracking with us. And that, you know, just to be able to keep this in perspective, that after this short assignment on earth, then there's much more to come for eternity.
And also finally, that we will be having our first Pamoja course online, and this will be launched on the 28th of June. And so this is, Pamoja course is just a part of showing that you'd love to be part of us and a member at One Tribe. And so it's just a session to let you know what we do at One Tribe, what we are all about, what we stand for, and would encourage those of you who have done, who came for the newcomer session also to join us. Or if you've been to other newcomer sessions and you've not gotten a chance to join Pamoja course, would encourage you to register and RSVP through Gloria. The numbers will be shared on the screen, and it will be nice to just come and hear what are we about for, and mostly also for accountability, because when we become members of a family, we look out for each other, and through Pamoja we'll get to know you better, and you'll get to know us as One Tribe better.
Thank you so much for making time to listen to us, and we are praying for you that even as we continue to think about this this time and going through life during this time, that God will just make His face shine upon you, give you peace, and just reveal Himself to you, reveal His goodness to you, and continue to provide for you in every way. So let us pray. Lord, we are grateful this afternoon. Thank you because you are a good God. You are faithful, you're gracious, and there is no one else like you. Thank you because you're reminding us that what we need in life, we have it. You've provided for us and everything that we have. You've provided for us everything that we need for life and godliness. And even Lord, as we look at our life bags, we pray that you help us to remove anything that is not required and add anything that is required in it, so that we may be adequately equipped to deal with life, adequately equipped to have a relationship with our friends, our family, and our in all every situation in our lives. So we honor you. We pray that Lord, you continue to be glorified in our lives. Bless us. Keep being glorified in our lives. We honor you and praise you. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.